this video, I'm going to talk about how to talk so kids will listen. As an educator and as a mother, I know the value of upbringing the kids or managing kids' behaviors when it comes to that. Most of us sometimes feel frustrated, disturbed, out of control, hopeless, and angry. So keep watching this video if you want to learn how to talk to kids so the kids will listen to you. Now, first of all, you need to understand that any conflict that we have with children in our lives, whether you're a teacher or you're a parent or you're taking care of young children, it's all to do with a gap of communication, a gap of skills that could help us to connect better, that could help us to gel better, that could help us to tune with each other better and understand each other better. So it's all about the communication skills, how adept your communication skills are, how adept you are at understanding children, how adept you are at understanding child psychology. I love children. I love teaching them. I loved bringing up my son, and I made sure that unless it's a physical pain, he doesn't have to go through any kind of mental pain. So I always made sure the way I communicated with my son kept the joy and smile on his face. I tried to resolve the issue with him through a better, successful communication that kids love. So what is the communication style that is so dear to the children? Children will never stop doing the things if you're shouting at them, if you're trying to boss them, if you're trying to give orders to them. Remember, children have an authority. Children are independent units. They have the minds that are growing at their own developmental speed. So whatever developmental stages they are, if you do not understand how to deal and do not have an understanding of those developmental stages, the chances are you are going to feel a sense of powerlessness around your child. So educate yourself about the development needs of the children at different ages, and that's really going to give you some tools and strategies on how to communicate with children of different age ranges. How you can communicate with a kindergartner or 2-year-old, it will be totally different when you're talking to 5-year-old or 6-year-old child. So in order to communicate with children, the first thing is try to win the trust of your child. And how can you win the trust of your child? You can win the trust of your child by giving him respect, by giving him a status of equality. Most of the times we feel that we are adults and we have to upbring our children. But I think it's the other way around. We are learning through our children. Our children are our teachers, and we just have to learn through them. Any kind of challenging situation that you come across, you really have to pause and be more mindful of that situation. So that is the first thing you can do. Anytime you feel that your child is not listening to you, instead of reacting or instead of feeling a sense of anger or powerlessness around your child, it's time to take a pause, a mindful breather, a big breather. And I can assure you, it is a process of not only loving yourself, it is a process of loving your child more as well. So anytime you feel that you want to shout at your child, you're feeling angry at your child is not listening to you, you're disappointed in your child, you're feeling hopeless in your child, it is time that you take a big pause, a mindful pause, take a big breather, and try to connect with yourself that what is lacking in your conversation with your child. Where is the gap? What are the tools and skills and strategies that you need to learn that could help you to connect better with your child? So in order to talk so the kids will listen, we need to educate ourselves in the needs and wants of the child and the developmental stages, and we need to become more aware of and equip ourselves with the communication tools and skills that could help our children grow and become healthy individuals, better adults who could in turn give those gifts to their children. So it's very important that we try to bring up children who are neither narcissistic nor too low in their self-esteem. We have to bring up the children in the middle way, who are balanced adults whose nervous system is in homeostasis, who do not feel either inferior or superior. They are compassionate adults. They are kind adults. They have a sense of empathy. They are creative. And they could contribute, not only do something great in their lives, but they could contribute and make others' lives better. So in order to create that range of mindset or core belief system in our children, we first need to educate ourselves, because the foundation of it lies since you get pregnant or the child comes into your life. From the newborn child till 7 years of age are the most crucial period in the life of any child. So if you are a mom who fails to spend much time with your child, I would advise you to become more aware that you're giving a lifelong gift to your child if you can spend more and more time educating yourself around parenting and about the different lifestyle developmental stages in your child's life, and spend more time to learn to talk so that your child will listen. I'm going to share with you one communication tip that you can use. If you find that your child is not listening to you, and it's time to start creating a conversation loop with your child where you can directly ask your child, could you please tell me why you're not listening to me? How many of us do that? Instead of asking this question, we are adept at saying all other things. You are making me angry. Why aren't you listening to me? What is your problem? What has happened to you? Or we talk all those words, but do we get ourselves to ask our children, could you please tell me why you're not listening to me, with full respect? Just asking that question, you will see a response coming from your child that would be providing you a more ground to go further in your communication with your child. So the communication, it's about learning a communication skill that is going to be win-win, not only for you, but for your child as well. So in that communication, what you're doing is you're trying to give respect to your child. You're trying to bring him into the communication as an equal partner, as an equal participant. So when we fail to bring in our children and give them that respect of an equal participation, that problems begin to crop up. So try to give respect to your child every time you are feeling angry. Remember, it's your anger, and you are the one who is the container of your anger, and you have to come up with something that could help you to love yourself and love your child. And the answer lies in learning better communication skills. The answer lies in respecting your children and understanding that shouting or stringent ways of punishing your children is never going to work. It is going to make your child withdraw from you, and it is going to also shut their hearts around you. So keep your hearts open, keep your hearts big, and help grow the children who have bigger hearts and who could not only love themselves, but love you and love others around them. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I will be making more videos on parenting, interpersonal communication skills, and how to do communicate with your kids, and more ideas around nourishing balanced children who have a great sense of self-esteem. Do subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the notification bell and give it a thumbs up if you like this video. And I will stay in touch with you. Till then, you stay blessed.